your Boston housing market forecast. What I'd like to do here is cut through all the hyperbolic statements about market turmoil and give you the straight dope from a broker's perspective. As someone who is doing this every day, talking to buyers and sellers and renters in Boston, I'm Craig Power with Power Realty Advisors, serving Greater Boston and the South Shore, coming to you from the Fenway neighborhood. And is anybody else sick of this never-ending bad news cycle, right? For 5 minutes here, let's just block out all the noise and let me tell you what's really going on with Boston real estate. Now, for years, I've been saying no real estate, market crash. You can check the tape. To this point anyway, I've been right. Let's start with interest rates and inventory, how we got here to this moment in time. Early 2022, we had low rates and therefore insane competition, multiple bids, waiving contingencies at a ridiculous level. It was unhealthy. Throughout 2022, the Fed raises rates at a record pace and the market moves slower. By the end of the year, we have slight price declines, not too dramatic, but definitely lower values simply because people's buying power is way down. The key thing you should understand is there's still not much inventory. For there to be a crash, we would need a major flood of inventory. That's what happened in 2008, short sales, foreclosures. That's not happening now, because in the larger context, property for sale in the greater Boston area is actually kind of scarce, and the need for it, the demand for it, is still massive. My goal here is to make you a more informed real estate consumer. So if you're gonna take one thing away from this video, I hope it's this: pick your poison, right? When you're buying a home, you're either gonna deal with high borrowing costs or high competition or some combination of the two. It's like a fulcrum, right? So the further over here we get with high interest rates, that's a negative, but it's more of a one-on-one negotiation, right? Where you can include more contingencies, you can negotiate terms more. The further over here you get with low interest rates, that's great, but the competition will heat up. At the time I'm recording this, the end of 2022, it's still high rates. If something comes on the market well-priced for today's circumstances, for today, there will still be competition. So that interest rate seesaw, that tool is what turns competition up and down in the short term. We should also talk briefly about the ridiculous rents in Boston. If ever there was a reason to buy, this is a good one. Did you hear the news, guys? We did it. We officially have the second highest rents in the country, surpassing San Francisco. Isn't that great? No, it sucks. And there are a lot of reasons for it. Prohibitive zoning, high demand, anything new that gets built is a luxury building. But if you're watching this, this is what we want you to do. If you're a hopeful buyer, we want to get you off the renter hamster wheel of paying someone else's mortgage. And I want to talk strategy for a minute. Because of the scarcity, people are gradually adopting this buy and hold real estate mindset. I feel like I have a unique perspective on this because we do sales, we do rentals, and we manage properties. The strategy I love for buyers anywhere around Boston today is getting out of the rental, buying, you know, the two-bedroom condo, for example, and making it a 3 to 5 year plan, living in it for 3 to 5 years, and then renting it out and keeping it as an investment later. Finding something that works for you today while keeping in mind the investment potential later. If the problem for the foreseeable future is scarcity, and I'm saying it is, then you probably want to stay in the market. And if you don't want to be a landlord, you just hand the keys to a professional property manager like me, like myself, and simply collect rental income. This is how people are seeing the housing market today. Why sell when you can continue to build wealth? It's pretty easy to make an income producing property fit into your long-term plan. The remaining two questions you probably have: what can we expect for pricing in 2023? And what other variables should we be watching in 2023? Price-wise, I would say it depends on what the Fed does and where rates top out. If rates are trending upward, prices should be stable or showing the slightest decline. If we start seeing a downtrend in rates, prices will start moving back up. The variables to watch, and keep in mind, my qualifications here are super limited. I know real estate because I see it every day. Any significant market decline, if that were to happen, I don't think it would come from within the housing industry. 2023 is projecting to be a hard year, so make smart decisions, live within your means, Don't run up your credit. Don't be impulsive. Be financially conservative. To wrap up, while I have your attention, I think I have a somewhat political message, which is that I believe housing is the issue of our time. We might not realize it yet. The consistently rising age of the first-time buyer, the economic outlook for millennials and Gen Z is really kind of bullshit, and I want to call more attention to it. It's an example of wealth inequality. We really do have a type of age inequality where young people are getting locked out of the housing market. I'm increasingly concerned about it, and we need to talk about it more. That's it. Thanks for watching. If you are making plans to buy, sell, invest in Boston, please get in touch. I want to know how we can help you achieve your goals. Contact me anytime. Craig@powerrealtyboston.com. Contact me through our website. Call me. Whatever I can do to be a resource for you, I'll always respond. Thanks again, and have a great 2023.